Now let's talk about the ePortfolio. The ePortfolio is a tool which allows you to collect a number of artifacts and resources into one spot that you can easily view and manage them all. And it's located inside of your D2L page. To access ePortfolio, click on the Tools drop-down menu, and then click on ePortfolio. From there, you'll be brought to your ePortfolio homepage. On your homepage, you have a number of resources, including a feed which shows you the resources that you've updated or worked on or have been shared with you from other people most recently. On the top of that window are a number of different sorting options where you can filter them by objects that have been shared with you, objects you've created, people you've subscribed to, and a number of other options. Now to the right of that, we can see an area where we can see any invitations from other people to connect with them and see their work. Below that, we see the usage bar, which shows how much space you've used in your ePortfolio and how much space you have left. Now if we move up to the top, we can see four different tabs which allow us to go to different areas of the ePortfolio. We've been on the first one. Now next, let's move over to My Items. Under My Items, you see a list of all of the objects that you've created within ePortfolio. Right now, we have three. To view them, we can click on them where we're shown a preview of each different artifact. Or if we want to do other things, we can click the drop-down arrow at the end of their name, or we can view them, edit them, copy them, share them, delete them, add them to presentations, etc. Up on the top above the list, we can see a few more options, where we can sort them depending on what type they are, what type of artifact they are, if they're a presentation, or a number of other options. If we move up farther yet, we have more options. We can either create a new artifact, we can upload an artifact from our computer, and we can click on more actions to see other things such as adding to collections, deleting objects, etc. Additionally, on the very right-hand side, we can look at the artifacts we have and see if we've shared them with anyone else. For instance, this artifact has been shared with one other person. Now let's move on to the Explore tab. Under Explore, we can see the artifacts that have been shared with us from other people. Right here, we have one that has been shared with us from someone else, and we can see the time which it was shared. Additionally, we can sort these things similarly to how we could sort our own things to have things grouped by similar presentation and artifact types. Lastly is sharing groups. If we know that we're going to be sharing things with a similar group of people multiple times, we can create a sharing group. This will allow us to easily share things with multiple people without having to individually add each one. This allows sharing to be much more easy, quick, and convenient. That's ePortfolio.